legendary Peter Asher.
Thank you. It's very exciting to be here. So I'm going to tell you a quick little story about the song that we're going to do. Because when I think we were about 18, when a guy called Gordon Waller and I met at school. And I'd seen somebody else walking around with a guitar case, and we got to know each other. And we started singing together just to see what it sounded like. And we started playing pubs and clubs and coffee bars and any kind of gigs we could get. And finally, after a couple of years of all of this, we actually got signed up by EMI Records, which we were very excited about. And they told us they wanted to cut, you know, spend a day in Abbey Road Studios, or EMI Studios as it was then, and cut some tracks, see if we could come up with a single. So we, of course, were looking for songs. Now, at this time, and this is a bit of a roundabout story, it so happened that Paul McCartney and I were sharing the top floor of our family home in Wimpole Street in central London. Paul was living with us for a couple of years. And during the course of that, of course, I did get to hear some songs. And among the songs, some very good songs at that, among the songs I heard was one that he explained to me he'd never finished, but he'd written a little bit earlier, which was a song called A World Without Love. And what apparently had happened is John didn't think much of the song, and actually he would make fun of Paul for the lyrics, because the opening line is, "Please lock me away," which John thought was ridiculous, and he would say to Paul, "Okay, I will lock you away, the song's over." So clearly, the Beatles weren't going to do the song, and Paul hadn't even finished it, he'd sort of given up on it. But I said, "Look, we've got a real record deal now, we're going to go to the studio, can we have a go at that song? We'd like to try it in harmony." And Paul said, "Yes, you can." He gave me the lyrics, he taught me the song, and we went to the studio and cut it, and that, of course, became the song that changed my life, which I'm very grateful for. Now, of course, the thing is, we're going to do this song, the thing is that's interesting is Gordon and I, of course, our arrangement of it was as a duo. So it needs a duo to sing the song, in my humble opinion. And Gordon's no longer with us. He died about 12 or 13 years ago. So I'm proud to introduce you to the newest, youngest, coolest new duo in town, Peter and Lyle. This song also works really well as a sing-along. Now, I know, of course, that what you're thinking to yourself is, "Oh my God, this record was number one 60 years ago. How could I possibly know the words?" And it's true to say that, of course, I guess what I'm really saying is, if you're old enough to remember when the record was number one, you're probably too old to remember much of anything. Thank you, Steve. But in the meantime, I'm actually confident that the words will come back to you, you know, come fluttering over the mists of time, and you'll remember them. And so I invite you to sing along. And by the time we get to the last verse, which is, by the way, as they say, same as the first, so you will have sung it to practice it. I think you'll remember it perfectly. So I'm going to leave the last verse of the song entirely to you guys. So here we go. I'm very proud to do this special edition with Lyle of World Without Love. 2, 3, 4. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. Thanks.